While interfacing with officials from the Uganda Railway Corporation, the Parliamentary Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises discovered that a lot of railway properties have been irregularly sold to politicians and private individuals. Robert Mwesigwa, the MP for Mbarara North, and Major General Eli Kayanja are among those who have bought the properties.
These are your properties, so I want to be sure that you're saying Minister of Finance advised us sell property A, B, C, D, E. Is that what you're saying?
It was actually done by the Minister of Finance.
What was done?
The selling. The actual selling was done by Minister of Finance.
URC was not involved in selling of its properties. That's what you're saying.
URC was involved in terms of execution of the agreement, and I wasn't present at that time.
Led by their managing director, Stanley Sendegeya, they were grilled by the committee chaired by Nakawa West Member of Parliament, Joel Senyonyi, on the process of selling company properties, and they distanced themselves from the matter that the land was sold by the privatization unit under the Ministry of Finance.
The land was sold by PU. PU was officially sent to URC by government to handle the privatization process and deal with the sale of that land and everything that happened at the point of privatization. So, that's the right answer. URC never sold its land.
Properties are in prime areas. So how can you say that properties in prime areas are non-core? Then number two, if you did not participate in the wholesaling process, who was guiding either the ministry or whatever that these are non-core and therefore they should be disposed of? So want to know.
I think it would be ideal for the committee, when we invite you again, to invite also a member from that unit. Because you may use the cover of PU when some of the things were done by rail. Yes, I'm convinced. I know so many areas about PU. I was around. I know the party statute. I know what PU was saying. But majority of the things are no longer now in the hands of PU.
However, they gave contradicting submissions before the committee when Sarah Nambasa Masembe, the corporation secretary at Uganda Railways Corporation, confirmed that the corporation signed transfer forms of the land, which makes it a seller.
They were not considering the fact that they were not going to be used by the concessionaire RVR to run the business. So they were not considered. They were left to the holding company, which was URC at that time, which did not become like URAC. They wanted to be a holding company, but never went through parliament, so it never became. So at that time, because of that part statute in place, PU, which is Minister of Finance, were the ones advertising for these assets. They're the ones selling. They would only go to us to sign off the sales. We did not sign. The government person who was sent.
Your legal officer said you signed. Please be on record, Madam Legal Officer.
Because URC is the registered proprietor of the pieces of land, URC signed.
And who drew the agreements?
The agreements were still drawn by URC, I think with help of external cards.
Okay, so there you are.
Cannot verbally be expressed that this and this happened. We cannot proceed on rumor. And she appears to be even deceiving. Because some of these are legal and procedural matters in a transaction. When it comes to someone was sent, that means anyone can come and say, I've been sent. We want to see, first of all, any instrument sending by a particular individual to the corporation.
The committee pressed officials to establish the owner of the former plot for Uganda Railway Corporation on Nsambia land, where Miss Steele Hotel is located, and why Robert Mwesigwa is a notorious buyer of Uganda Railway Corporation land. The committee chairperson, Joel Senyonyi, asked for the original documents of Uganda Railway Corporation land, which was sold.
At least you mentioned him by name here. Others we are saying are encroachers. This one you specifically mentioned, Robert Mwesigwa. And also to add from Honorable's inquiry on Nsambia land, I hear that even where there is a Mestil Hotel, it was formerly land for you, for the corporation. Who is the buyer in that case?
Submit a list of the non-core assets to the chair, the committee, and tell us who took properties which were non-core.
To have that documentation to back up what you're saying. So that's why what you're saying is important. We want to capture it. Okay, so that's why we need to know from you, were you under duress, were not you not party? Because you see, eventually you can produce those documents and they instead prove that you were party to the sale.
In another development, the committee has discovered that Uganda Railways Corporation has not been remitting NSSF contributions of its employees. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.